I'm so jealous. I love these girls. They are so thin and they are so healthy. I wish I could be like them. I hate my body. I wish I could be like those models. But I have an idea. Tomorrow I will start my diet. As I said, I'm going to start my diet today. So I'm not going to eat anything at lunch. Yeah!
Hey, what are you doing? Aren't you eating anything for lunch?
No, I'm not. I am just like kind of fat and I need to lose weight in a radical way. I want to look like those Victoria's Secret models, like right now.
Well, starving or not eating at all won't definitely make you lose weight. This is not the proper way to do so, and thus, your metabolism will only get slower and slower. To lose weight, you need to have a proper healthy diet.
What? What is a healthy diet?
Great question. Well, I'm going to explain to you what exactly a healthy diet is.
A healthy diet is the one that helps to maintain or improve the general health of your body. This type of diet should give the nutrients all the different nutrients the body needs. These are nutrients, minerals, water, carbohydrates, vitamins, proteins, and lipids. A healthy diet provides energy without toxicity or gaining weight. Plus, to have a healthy diet, you should practice exercise, and then you could prevent obesity, heart disease, type 2 diabetes, and hypertension.
And do you know what is nutrition?
Nutrition? No, I don't remember nothing of that.
Well, nutrition is the process of obtaining nutrients from digestion.
Oh, I remember! In biology class we saw something like... It was called... Nutrients, I think? And I remember a lot of things.
Nutrients are something that nourishes their cells. There are 7 main kinds of nutrients. Minerals, water, carbohydrates, vitamins, proteins, and lipids. Nutrients are basically found in the food, that's why we need them so much. As a fun fact, fiber isn't a nutrient, but because it can be digested, it helps that your body can take out toxic materials. For saying it easier, it helps that you go more times to the bathroom, and then toxic materials leave faster your body.
But wait! Each different nutrient has a different purpose in our bodies.
Minerals. Minerals are inorganic substances found in rocks and soil which help in the immune health, muscle function, energy production, and bone and teeth health. Water. Water functions in our body are cell life, chemical and metabolic reactions, transport of other nutrients, body temperature, and its regulation and elimination of wastes. Carbohydrates. They are divided into 3 different groups: monosaccharide, disaccharides, and polysaccharides. The main role of this nutrient is to provide energy. Actually, it is a major source of energy. Its role as well includes providing energy for working muscles, providing fuel for the central nervous system, enabling fat metabolism and preventing that protein is used as a way for getting energy. Vitamins. Vitamins are required to the body but in small amounts. Their function is to promote normal growth, provide a proper metabolism, ensure good health, and protect against some diseases. Vitamins can be found in fruits and vegetables. Proteins. Proteins are divided into 2 different groups: essential amino acids, the ones the body cannot synthesize, and non-essential amino acids, the ones that the body can synthesize. Its main functions are required for building and repair of body tissues, essential body processes such as water balancing, nutrient transport and muscle contractions, energy, and help to keep the skin hair and nails healthy. Lipids. Lipids are another word for fats. Cholesterol and triglycerides are lipids. Lipids are easily stored in the body. They serve as a source of fuel and are an important constituent of the structure of cells. Lipids include fatty acids, neutral fats, waxes, and steroids, like cortisone.
Oh yes, in that biology class, we learned a new and easy method for having a healthy diet. It was called the food pyramid. It's a triangle in which says the amount of food you should eat of each nutrient. Carbohydrates were at the bottom. We should eat a lot of carbohydrates because they are a really good source of energy, as we said before. Then, it goes out the fruits and veggies. Proteins and fats. As you can see, in top one it's a small triangle because we should eat a small amount of fats. Carbohydrates are a really big square because we should eat a lot of carbohydrates for having more energy. Fruits and vegetables we should eat in the same amount, and we should eat in a kind of middle amount. As well as the proteins, but in a less amount than fruits and vegetables. Using the food pyramid, we can have a healthy diet. It is an extremely easy method for remembering how much amount of food we should eat of each nutrient.
So, Manuela, our third lesson is gonna be what food you can eat for having a healthy diet. So, let's get started. So, here I brought some nutrients that are really good, like if you're trying to lose weight or to have a healthy, balanced diet. Here with me, I have vegetables and fruits. So this fruit here I have in my hand is an orange. Oranges are really good for your body because they contain vitamin C as well as lemon. Vitamin C is very, very important because it helps to boost your immune system, and also it is a very good vitamin because it helps you, it improves like to lose weight. So I really recommend you, if you're looking to lose weight, to consume lemons or having an orange juice, which is very good. Then here in my other hand, I have an apple. Apples are a very good source of vitamin A. This fruit is very complete and it contains a lot of fiber, so I really recommend it to you. Then here I have a vegetable, which is a tomato. Tomatoes have 95% of water. They are a very good source of potassium and magnesium. They contain vitamin B1, B2, and B5. There are also other vegetables which are very, very important for your diet, as well as carrots. Carrots are well commonly known because they help you, and they say there have been scientific investigations that they say that carrots improve your vision, like it helps for your eyes. Carrots contain potassium. They also are a very good source of vitamin A and have a small amount of phosphorus. Other vegetables which are similar to carrots in vitamins and properties are spinach
and parsley.
However, the fruits and vegetables I just mentioned to you, they're not only the only ones that are very good for having a healthy diet. Of course, there are hundreds of others, but these were the ones that I was able to show to you. But now, we also have carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are a very good source of energy. So here I have some rice, as you can see. Ta-da! And then We have also pasta, which is also a carbohydrate, and bread, and of course cereal, which is crucial like for having meat for breakfast. It is very, very important for you to consume carbohydrates, because apart from giving you energy, which is the energy that is necessary for helping you perform your day, carbohydrates, as you, Manuela, explained it before, are at the bottom of the pyramid, and it's very important to consume them. Other food which is very important to consume in your healthy diet are proteins. Proteins are very good because they help you to repair your muscle, and here I brought some examples so that you can see and that you can have an idea so that you can consume them. Here we have milk. Milk is a very good source not only of protein but also of calcium. Calcium is very good for your bones. So I recommend you, if you're consuming milk, to buy the one that is like skim milk, so because it doesn't contain a lot of fat. So this will help you not to gain a lot of weight. Then we have yogurt, which is also like similar to milk, but it's yogurt. And I also recommend you to use the one that is skim, like it doesn't have too much fat. Apart from dairies, we also have like eggs, which are a very good source of protein. These are very good, for example, if you're a vegetarian, you can consume them and have the same properties, like eggs are actually a substitute of meat. But also we have this meat, which I recommend you, it is like a lean meat. So that you don't get fat. And also you can eat chicken but without skin. We also have fish, which is a very source of protein. We have tuna, and is also a very good source of omega-3. And cheese, of course, which is also part of the dairy one.
Now, the food that we all like, fat. Lollipops, chocolates, potato chips, and ice cream. But there are some fats that are good, but there are others that are bad. Nuts, for example. We all love nuts. They're delicious, they're healthy, they give a lot of energy. But as you can see, I had already ate them all. They are delicious. You should try them in your daily meals. Ice cream. We all love ice cream. It's delicious, it has sugar, it can be chocolate or strawberry ice cream, but we should stop eating a lot of ice cream. If you want to eat ice cream, eat in small amounts and not a lot of time. Bacon, we all love having bacon at breakfast, but it has a lot of fats. This can cause heart disease by blocking our arteries. So it's better if you consume less amount of bacon and once in a month. Candies, Nutella, cookies. Please leave it for all the time. You can eat every day Nutella. It is really bad and you can get fat. And then you can lose the energy and feel sick. Potato chips. Also, they say that they have protein, guys. They have protein, but not the one that you need. You should stop eating there too much and concentrate on having a healthy diet. If you are cooking meat or chicken, you should try virgin oil. It's really healthy compared to the others.
But wait, we're missing something, and I guess you really know what are we missing, and yeah, we're missing water. Water is a very, very important like factor that you should include to your healthy diet. I really recommend you to drink at least 8 glasses of water each day. This will help you for your skin, it also boosts up your metabolism, and water contains a lot and really, really a lot of benefits for your body. So, as I said, It is very important. I'm gonna drink a glass of water.
If you are vegetarian, you should be aware that you have to replace the proteins given by chicken, meat, and fish. But if you are vegan, you should be aware more. Tofu, it's a good way for getting all of those proteins, as well as other grains that can give you the proteins as meat. Be aware because you don't have the same amount of proteins in those other kinds of food. So you should consult an expert of the topic for knowing which kind of food you can eat depending on your beliefs. Nutrition and the kind of food you eat, it's really different around the world, depends on what culture or religion or country you are.
Digestion is the process in which food is break up. This means nutrients. Nutrients are break up by enzymes, which are a biologic catalyst. Their shape allows the enzymes to function. There are different types of enzymes for each nutrient because they have different shapes. Amylase is for carbohydrates, protease for protein, and lipase for fats. Enzymes function is affected by temperature, pH, and substance concentration. Enzyme shape is known as conformation. The active site is the part of the enzyme that bonds with the substance. Intramolecular bonds make the actual shape, conformation, which led the enzyme to work. Changing the intramolecular bond will affect how the enzyme works. Different enzymes are produced in different parts of the body. Amylase is produced in the salivary glands, pancreas, and the small intestine. Protease are produced in the stomach, the pancreas, and the small intestine. Lipase is produced in the pancreas and in the small intestine. As a summary and conclusion, amylase catalyzes the breakdown of starch into sugars in the mouth and small intestine. Protease catalyze the breakdown of proteins into amino acids in the stomach and the small intestine. Lipase catalyze the breakdown of fats and oils into fatty acid and glycerol in the small intestine.
Yummy fact!
Yummy fact!
Yummy fact! Yummy fact!
Number one! There are around 2,000 plant types that humans use to cultivate food.
Number two! China is the largest producer of garlic. It produces 10 million tons in 2008, according to an study.
Number three! Around 8% of children and 2% of adults have some kind of food allergies. Common examples of food allergies are peanuts, gluten, and seafood.
Number 4. Different parts of the world have their different antigens. These can differ for different factors like diets, religion, economic, social, as well the access of food, depending on the weather or the conditions of the land.
Number 5. Human food is typically made from plants and animals, but we also consume fermented food and foods. Oh my god, Manuela, you have lost so much weight! Did you follow my advice?
Of course, Vera. Instead of drinking Coke, I have water. Instead of having a hamburger, I have tuna, which gives me protein. I'm having a better strength in my muscles. Instead of having a